Compare the kinetic energy of a moving bullet with that of a large rolling boulder. You might be surprised to know that the kinetic energy of the bullet could exceed that of the boulder. Let us try to understand why that is possible. So, the kinetic energy of an object is associated with its mass and velocity. And if you observe this kinetic energy formula closely, you will see that the velocity has a lot more influence on the kinetic energy than mass, simply because it changes as the square of velocity. So, if you have a mass of 1 kilogram moving at a velocity of 2 meters per second, the kinetic energy is half into 1 kilogram into 2 meters per second square, that equals 2 joules. Now, if you double the mass, the kinetic energy becomes half into 2 square, that equals 4 joules. However, if you double the velocity while keeping the mass same, the kinetic energy becomes half into 1 into 4 square, that equals 8 joules. So you see, a change in velocity has a much larger effect on the kinetic energy of the object than a change in mass. And that is what explains why a bullet, which typically moves at very high velocity of over 300 meters per second, is able to match the kinetic energy of a boulder, which is much larger in mass, but in normal course would not reach these kind of velocities. Now, when you apply force to an object, you are basically accelerating it. And acceleration means you are increasing its velocity. So, you can say that when you apply force, you are increasing the kinetic energy of the object. And we explain this increase in kinetic energy by saying that the force you applied transferred energy to the object from you. And therefore, it makes sense to say that in such a transfer of energy via this force, work W has been done on the object by this constant force. And we say positive work has been done by the force on the object. However, if you decelerate the object to a lesser velocity by applying a force, you are decreasing the kinetic energy of the object, and energy from the object is getting transferred to you. And since this reduction in kinetic energy of the object is happening on account of this force, we say that this force is doing negative work on the object. Simply put, if the force helps increase the velocity of an object, we say it is doing positive work. But if it slows it down or reduces its velocity, we say it is doing negative work. Now, the term transfer of energy can be a little misleading. It does not mean that anything material or physical flows into or out of the object. That is, the transfer is not like a flow of water. A better way of explaining energy transfer would be that it is like the electronic transfer of money between two bank accounts. The number in one account goes up when you transfer money, while the number in the other account goes down, with nothing physical passing between the two accounts. So, let us now go ahead and find the magnitude of work done by a force acting on an object. And to do so, we will push a box of mass M with a force F. Now, since there is a force acting on the box, it must accelerate the box. And when it accelerates, the velocity of the box changes. And when the velocity changes, so does the kinetic energy of the box. Now, with this in the background, let us derive the expression for work done by a force. So, using Newton's second law of motion, we can say that F is equal to ma. Also, let us say the box undergoes a displacement d and its velocity changes from an initial velocity v naught to some velocity v. Then, we can use the equation v square is equal to v naught square plus 2ad to connect all these quantities. And if we rearrange the equation like this, that is half v square minus half v naught square equals ad, and then substitute a is equal to f upon m from this equation, what we get is half mv square minus half mv naught square equals F into D. Now, this term here is the expression for kinetic energy of the box at the end of the displacement D, and this one is the kinetic energy at the beginning. So, this difference therefore gives you the change in kinetic energy of the box due to force F when it undergoes displacement D, and this is equal to force into displacement. And we say that this change in the kinetic energy of the box is equal to the work done by the force on the box. And this is how we get the famous equation W, or the work done, equals F into D, or force into displacement. Now, a couple of other points you should remember, because I've seen this is where students often make mistakes. Number one is, work is a scalar quantity even though both force and displacement are vectors. So, a force of 10 Newton acting in north and moving the object by 20 meter will do the same amount of work that a force of 10 Newton acting west and causing a similar displacement of 20 meters. Number two is, the condition for using this equation is that the force should be a constant, both in magnitude and direction, as the object moves. The third one is, if there is more than one force acting on an object and you're asked to find the work done on the object by all forces, you could approach this in two ways. First approach is, find the work done by each force as if the other forces do not exist, and then sum up the work done by various forces. The other approach could be, you take the vector sum of all the forces and find the resultant force, and then find the work done by that resultant force. You will get the same answer with both approaches. So if you want to sharpen your understanding around the work energy theorem and the idea of potential energy, I would suggest you head over to this playlist. And like always, if you like the video, do give a thumbs up or subscribe if you've not done already, and I'll see you in the next video.